वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक 6M सब्जेक्ट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस। माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। सो ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टार्टेड फॉर डिफरेंट इश्यूज इन्वॉल्व इन NLP। सो वी हैव इन लास्ट वीडियो डिस्कस अबाउट लैंग्वेज मॉडल्स n-gram characters, Markov chain, and smoothing n-gram models and model evolution, and last n-gram word models. Now today's topic is text classification. So let us start with it. So we now consider in depth the task of text classification, also known as categorization. And given a text of some kind, decide which of a predefined set of classes it belongs to, and language identification and generic classifications are example of text classification. As is sentiment analysis or and spam detection. Since not spam is awkward, and researchers have coined the term HAM for not spam, so we can treat spam detection as a problem in supervised learning. And a training set is readily available. The possible spam examples are in my spam folder or your or any spam folder. The negative HAM examples are in boxes like this. So here some spam messages like here, and ham messages also here. From this excerpt we can start to get an idea of what might be good feature to include in the supervised learning model. So word n-gram such as for cheap and you can buy seem to be indicators of spam, and characters level features also seem important, and spam is more likely to be all uppercase and to have punctuations embedded in words, and the spammer thought that the word bigram you deserve would be too indicative of spam, and thus wrote you deserve. Instead, a character model should detect this. So you can see a reference book for this example, and we could either create a full character n-gram model of spam and ham, or we could handcraft features such as a number of punctuation marks embedded in words. So there is another two complementary ways of talking about classification. In the language model approach, we define one n-gram language model for p probability message message given spam by training on the spam folder, and one model for probability message given ham by training on the inbox. Then we can classify a new message with an application of Bayes rule. So here you can see the Bayes rules for spam and ham. So argmax, so here c belongs to spam and ham. So probability c given message is equal to argmax c belongs to spam ham, and probability of message given c into probability of c. So where probability of c is estimated just by counting the total number of spam and ham messages, and this approach works well for spam detection just as it did for language identification. And in machine learning approach, we represent the message as a set of features or value pairs and apply a classification algorithm H to the feature vector X. So we can make the language modeling and machine learning approach computable by thinking of the n-gram as feature. This is easiest to see with a unigram model, and the features are the words in the vocabulary small a or AARDVARK, and the values are the number of times each word appears in the message. That makes the feature vector large and sparse. If there are 1 lakh words in the language model, then the feature vector has length 1 lakh, but for a short email message, almost all the features will have count 0. This unigram representation has been called the bag of words model. So you can think of the model as putting the words of training corpus in a bag and then selecting words on one at a time. So the notion of order of the words is lost. A unigram model gives the same probability to any prematuration of a text, and higher order n-gram models maintain some local notion of word orders. So with higher gram and trigram, the number of features is squared or cubed, and we can add in other non-n-gram features, and the time the message was sent, whether a URL or an image is the part of the message, and ID number for the sender of the message, and the sender number of previous spam and ham messages, or so on. So the choice of features is the most important part of creating a good spam detector, and more important than the choice of algorithm for processing the feature. So in part of this, because there is a lot of training data, so if we can propose a feature, the data can accurately determine if it is good or not. It is necessary to constantly update features because spam detection is an adversarial task, and the spammers modify their spam in response to the spam detector's changes. And it can be expensive to run algorithm on a very large feature vectors. So often a process of feature selection is used to keep only the features that best discriminate between spam and ham. And for example, here the bigram of the is frequent in English and may be equally frequent in spam and ham. So there is no sense in counting it. Often the top 100 or so features do a good job of discriminating between classes. And once we have chosen a set of features, we can apply any of the supervised learning techniques. And popular one for text categorization include K nearest neighbors, and support vector machines, decision trees, naive bayes, and logistic regression. All of these have been applied to spam detection, usually with accuracy in the 98 to 99% range. With a carefully designed feature set, accuracy can exceed 99.9%. So the last topic of our text classification is classification by data compression. So another way to think about classification is as a problem in data compression. A lossless compression algorithm takes a sequence of symbols, detects repeated patterns in it, and writes a description of the sequence that is more compact than the original. So here an example, the text 0.14285714285714285 might be compressed to 0.514285 to power 3. So compression algorithm works by building dictionaries of subsequence of the text and then referring to entries in the dictionary. So the example here had only one dictionary entry, 142857. In fact, compression algorithms are creating a language model. So the LZW algorithm in particular directly models a maximum entropy probability distribution, and to do classification by compression, we first lumps together all the spam training messages and compress them as a unit. So we do the same for ham here. And then we in given a new message to classify, we append it to the spam messages and compress the result. We also append it to the ham and compress that. Whichever class compresses better adds the fewer number of additional bytes for the new message. and is the predicted class, and the idea is that spam message will tend to share dictionary entries with other spam messages and thus will compress better when appended to a collection that already contains the spam dictionary. And experiment with compression based classification on some of the standard corpora for text classification, such as 20 newsgroups dataset, the Reuters 10 corpora and the industry sector corpora indicates that whereas running of the self compression algorithm like ggip, rar and LZW can be quite slow, their accuracy is comparable to traditional classification algorithms, and this is interesting in its own right and also serves to point out that there is a promise for algorithms that use character and gram directly with no pre-processing of the text or feature selection. So they seem to be capturing some real pattern. So here we complete our text classification. So the session ended here, and thank you.